I was going to tell everybody's been doing studies and little bits of trivia here and there, but this little tidbit of information is a little less known. I didn't find this in Uncle John's bathroom reader, Christmas edition, but apparently it's true. It's called Santa Goes Mowing. In Christmas books, in songs and poems, Santa Claus comes to our home. One year, a kid went down the stairs and saw him kiss his mother there. Some say he cut their Christmas tree. Some say that he's Elvis Presley. Maybe you've heard some folks discuss that Santa's a Bayman like us. We know on a Christmas Eve he flies with presents for the girls and boys. He has to take the shortest path, use time zone charts and fancy math to make the round in one big trip while making sure no homes are skipped. But there's one detail no one knows, and this is how the story goes. He left from the pole up north and got prepared to sally forth, first green man. Then he looked around and started working his way down. 2 hours before the light of day, he would be left to marry Kay, with red sleigh and Noel regalia, 6 o'clock he'd leave Australia. When he had ticked off Canada, he clicked his heels, said, "Fa-la." Newfoundland and Labrador. Next year, I'll need more manpower, but with that extra half an hour, I figure I can do that all and go back, and Christmas won't be spoiled. In short time, he turned and said, "Nah, I covered name to pass it now." Now to cross this little straight, go from 9 to 8. Soon after he began his start, he saw the homes were miles apart. Now his efficiency was shot, the reindeer bit by two a snap. But this he wasn't well prepared. The roads weren't straight or lined up square. He needed bearings, but each address did not show on his GPS. As if that wasn't bad enough, the weather started getting rough. And so the forecast he did check, a wind warning is in effect. When he went into one small town, he saw folks dancing all around, but he could party as he works, being Santa has his perks. But so as not to blow his cover, Santa dressed up like a mummer. He stripped off and went about to turn his red suit inside out. With that big sack stuffed in his sleigh, old Santa got carried away. He found some size 2 skidoo suits and pulled them out over his boots. He put on drawers for some kid's nan and some poppy's wool pants on his hands. Pulled his white beard over his face and with brown tights kept it in place. The reindeer harnessed 2 abreast were quite relieved to take a rest. As Santa showed up on the scene, one man said, "Ah, I bet that's Eugene!" "Oh, what's he got there in that sack he's dragging around me on his back?" "I bet you that that's his brother, bringing dirty clothes to mother." It was a hand to dance and sing with all his new friends, Jenny, thinking, "I hope no one sees me putting gifts under these trees." One man approaching him, he saw wearing his mom's 42 bra, passed a drink that looked conniving, but Santa said, "No thanks, I'm dry." He saw the clock and he said, "Wow, I've got to leave this place right now." Nobody saw him leave except one girl who off his feet, he swept. He danced and sang with her the most in that small town in the South Coast. Under the beard, though, he did wonder, will she love this old face on her? By now he had fell way behind. But new love and reindeer combined makes magic that can't be explained. Can't be seen and can't be contained. And so he went and woke her up, and all the others soon told up. "And there's your dancer, come on, boys, we'll get around so that we die." Leave out all the trip details, they finally got the New South Wales in record time. For out of mind was the girl he left behind. The Newfoundland, just like her mummer. Next year he'll go down in summer. As for now, to the North Pole, before Blitzen loses control. The reindeer let out one big squeal and happily flew home from New Zealand. When all the Christmas rush died down, no elves and reindeer gone around, Santa had all the time he needed, his heart said go, and he proceeded. He went to Newfoundland, no doubt, not sure how, I'll leave that out. Went straight down to the South Coast, back to that house and his fine host. Nobody knew, but now I'll say that Mrs. Claus is from France.